Hi, I'm the Shadow Snows, and I'm back with episode 2 of my Test Drive Unlimited series. Yeah, I cannot connect. So how do I...
This icon lets you start a race in solo mode.
Which one is it?
To find your way...
Yeah, let's try this. Doesn't really matter at the beginning. Most of those races are easy.
3, 2, 1, go!
And since I've got the fastest car, they are really easy. And I'm not sure if the game is calculating slipstream and such things.
Turn right. Turn left. Turn left.
Yeah, it really helps. I have the fastest car.
Turn left.
But those F-class cars are all pretty crappy, so...
At the next intersection, turn right. Turn right.
Oh, that was a little bit optimistic. Come on. Reverse. Fuck. How do I... Not this key. That
turn
key.
Turn right.
And I'm saying that the first races are very easy. Let's try this again. And be a little less optimistic. I get a little bit of money anyways. So it wasn't a complete waste.
3, 2, 1, go!
And for some reason you always start in the last position.
At the next intersection, turn right. Turn right. Turn left. Turn left.
Really, the first races should not be very hard. And right now I'm just trying to earn some money to tune this car.
Turn left. At the next intersection, turn right. Turn right.
And I really should switch the display to reasonable units, not miles. No, I'm not going to retry this. And I think, yeah, that's the map. Let's race against the clock. Yeah, those first races are really boring if you've already done them a couple of times.
At the next intersection, turn left. Turn left.
Oh, this car is horrible.
Turn left. Turn left.
And really, as long as you don't make any major mistakes.
At the next intersection, turn left.
You shouldn't have.
Turn left.
Too much problems to win the first races. Another easy one. And if you have been close to a checkpoint, then you don't have to drive there.
Your itinerary is being recalculated.
But especially in the beginning, it's not too bad of an idea.
You start a time trial in solo mode. Your destination is 1.5 miles away.
Because you have to discover places. So if you haven't driven by a store, you can't see it on the map. And also you get achievements for
1 mile away. Your itinerary is being recalculated.
The distance you have traveled on this island. Oh shit. And this cop thing is a little bit like the star ranking.
You have reached your destination.
In GTA. And especially if you got quite a lot of stars, it's really hard to lose them.
Turn left.
Shit! I lost quite a bit of time there.
Turn left.
And still easily winning the race. And that pretty much shows how easy the first races are. Thank you.
Your itinerary is being recalculated. This icon lets you start a race in solo mode.
And yes, those tutorial messages disappear after a while.
Your destination is 1.5 miles away. At the next intersection, turn left. Turn left.
Probably a wise idea not to bump into the cops.
Your destination is 1 mile away. Turn right. Your itinerary is being recalculated.
And I'm really looking forward to when I can buy my first C-class vehicle. Then it becomes quite a bit more interesting.
Your destination is a half a mile away. At the next intersection,
this icon lets you start a race in solo mode.
Let's start this race. Well, I have already... Yes, I've already done it, so...
You are driving in the wrong direction. Please turn around. Turn right.
Oh, not here.
This woman would appreciate help with her shopping bags.
Turn right.
Yeah, those are
this icon lets
missions.
You start a time trial in solo mode.
Yeah, I think when I not rookie anymore.
3, 2, 1, go!
Those tutorial messages disappear. A 245 reference score. So this is already one of the
turn left
longer races for the beginner level. And that's one downside of this game. Most of the races are quite short. There are a couple of longer ones. Basically, there are two races.
Turn left. Turn left.
Make you race the entire island. It's the Island Tour and the Millionaires Challenge. And that means that you have to drive one single race for about 3/4 of an hour.
Turn left.
That was close. But only those two races are that long. Most of the races are like 5 minutes
Turn
or so.
Left.
And I think this game
at
would
the next intersection, turn left.
Really benefit from
turn left.
Having a steering wheel.
You are driving in the wrong direction. Please turn around.
Oh, I hate this car. And it's still the best of the F-Class cars, so you can imagine how horrible the others are. And I unlocked my first achievement. Ah, that's a vehicle delivery mission. Let's do this.
The owner of this automobile needs a ride to a repair shop.
I can do that.
You're taking to get it repaired? Okay. Just bring it back in good condition.
So, with these, the mission is basically not a single scratch. Stay on the road.
Go!
And those can be much longer than this one. This is only like 8 miles or so.
Turn right.
But they can also be
at the next
like 30 miles.
Turn left.
And since
turn
you're
left.
Not allowed to do a single scratch, they can be quite stressful. It's basically a test of patience. And I'm not the most patient guy in the world. I mean, it's in theory, it's not the end of the world if you
at the next intersection turn right.
Have a little collision.
Turn right.
But if you make this unscratched, you get. I'm not quite sure. I can't remember
turn
if
left.
It was 50% or 25% extra cash. So it's really not a bad idea to try to finish this without a scratch. Just take your time, there's no time limit on those. And I'm not even half the way through. See, I'm already getting impatient.
At the next intersection, turn right. Turn right. Turn left. At the next intersection, turn left. Turn left.
And the GPS, by the way, isn't perfect. In some races, it directs you into oncoming traffic. Basically, in the wrong direction of a one-way street. So if you follow the GPS in those races, it makes it much harder. And it had to be, because even in the races, it's open world, you can drive wherever you like. You just have to pass the checkpoints in the given order. And I'm just halfway through this mission. Oh yes, it really is a test of patience. And some driving skills, but more patience.
Turn right.
You can easily finish those missions without any driving skills if you're just patient enough.
You are driving in the wrong direction.
Yes, you could have
around.
Told me earlier that I should turn left. Same bitch as in my company Golf. I really hate that sat nav in this. That I have to drive to a repair shop is that I'm driving to a repair shop, so I get that on my map. Okay, 2 more miles. Oh shit. Yeah, and the AI cars don't drive too well. The good thing is, the driving meter only counts off-road and car collisions. So if there would be a tree in the middle of the road and I would crash into it full speed, it wouldn't affect the driving meter. So since the road is lined with concrete, shit! Yeah, that lost at least $20,000 or $30,000. That one thing, I'm not restarting this mission. I just have to deal with it. Then I've driven a specific amount of distance. And you get an achievement for that. I think the highest achievement you can get for distance is if you have driven 1,000 miles, which is quite a lot. Miles. Wow. Get an achievement for that. And I've leveled up, so I hope I don't get that many tutorial missions again. I need an e-car for that. I don't have one.
Your itinerary is being recalculated.
So let's do one more race in this video and then I'll end this episode, I think.
At the next intersection, turn right. Turn right. Your destination is a half a mile away.
And I've covered most of those 30 miles in this Audi. Oh, shit.
You have reached your destination.
And great, I've discovered the Chevrolet dealer. Not that I want to buy a car from him, but I could. Holy shit. And I have to remember that objects are harder in this game than in GTA. Fuck, the final checkpoint. I have to get them. Come on. Bloody car. Yeah, really a shame. Let's retry this. Shit. That went better than I feared. It's probably just don't spin. Because I should still have the fastest car. And now don't crash into anything, because the checkpoint's right there, yeah. Still easy enough if you don't make any major mistakes. But only $5,000 reward, that's nothing. So let's see if I already have any tuning shop. No, I don't. I think the TT is a vehicle with two seats. And those are pretty useless, because you only get coupons. Wait, to buy clothes.
I have an appointment and I'm in a hurry. Can you get me there fast? Like I said, I'm in a hurry.
Go!
At the next intersection, turn left.
Yeah, you basically get a time limit. And I'm not allowed to fuck the car up too much.
Turn left.
And you only get coupons as a reward. But they add to your achievements and they add to your level, and you need to get a higher level to
next intersection, turn left. Turn left.
Be able to drive the higher rated races. Oh shit! Oh, right now I'm more worried about not losing time than crashing, because you, I don't think you get an extra reward if you do this perfectly. Oh, it's getting close, and I have to brake at the right moment.
Could have been a bit faster.
That was close.
Not late. Thanks.
Okay, I think that's enough for this video. Hope you enjoyed it, and thanks for watching.